Hey everyone, welcome back. We're doing a deep dive today on this blog post that really got me thinking. It's called The Grammy Super Bowl Moment of Complete Self-Absorption, and it's by John McElhenney over at uber.law.
Okay.
And the basic premise is that he's using Taylor Swift's Grammy wins to kind of springboard into this larger discussion about AI. Pretty fascinating stuff.
I mean, what I find so interesting about it is that he manages to connect something like pop music to this larger philosophical question about the role of AI in our culture.
Yeah, and he makes some pretty bold claims too. Like, he actually says that AI is already churning out more content than every human on the planet combined.
Whoa.
Like, what does that even mean for us?
I think that's what makes this deep dive so interesting. He really goes into some deep stuff, like job displacement and environmental concerns.
Right.
Ethical dilemmas about AI content. He's even worried about this potential loss of human connection. Okay, so let's break this down a little bit. He specifically points to creative fields like marketing and advertising as being on the front lines of this whole AI wave, which makes sense when you think about it. AI's already writing copy, crafting social media posts, even creating video content.
And he argues that this is just the beginning. He actually envisions this thing he calls robot social, where AI content basically takes over our social media feeds.
Uh-oh.
You know, we're talking about a world where it's hard to even tell what's real and what's AI. He even brings up this concept of, like, fake personas.
Yeah.
AI-driven influencers that don't even exist.
Yeah, it's a little creepy.
It is kind of creepy.
It's definitely making me rethink how I scroll through my feed. I mean, if we're constantly being hit with this AI-generated content, is it going to drown out, like, the actual human voices?
Right.
And how will we know what to even trust?
And he does tap into that fear, I think, pretty well. He talks about the energy consumption, the possibility of AI making inequality worse, even the risk of us losing control as AI gets more sophisticated.
Okay, so we've got this potential loss of human connection. We've got the ethical questions about what's real and what's AI. And now the very real concern that AI could, like, spiral out of control. This is getting intense. But how does this actually apply to us? Like, why should we care about this?
Well, I think he brings up a good point when he says to think about the content you consume every day, the music you listen to, the videos you watch, the articles you read. How much of that is already being shaped or even created by AI?
I mean, probably more than we realize. Right?
Yeah, and that's exactly what he wants us to wake up to.
He also brings up some practical concerns. Like, what happens when AI starts replacing jobs that humans have always done? Like, he uses call centers as an example, which are already being heavily impacted by AI chatbots. But as AI gets smarter, who's to say that it won't start replacing jobs in, like, marketing, finance, healthcare?
It is a bit unsettling to think about that.
Yeah, it is.
This is bringing up a big question about the future of work. How do we even prepare for a world where AI can do so many of the tasks that we rely on humans for? What new skills will we need? What new industries will emerge? And how do we make sure that the benefits of AI are shared broadly and not just concentrated in the hands of a few?
That's a big question.
It is a big question, yeah. And picking up on that future of work thing, I think McElhenney doesn't really offer any easy answers, but he does challenge us to think about our relationship with technology. Like, are we really in control of AI, or is it starting to control us?
Right.
And what can we do to make sure it's used ethically?
It's a lot to unpack.
It is a lot to unpack.
And I think you hit on something really important there, this idea of AI subtly influencing us. He brings up this image of us being surrounded by these, like, synth avatars and this AI-generated content that's meant to keep us engaged but not necessarily informed or connected in a meaningful way.
Yeah, and he uses this Taylor Swift example of her winning album of the year 4 times to illustrate this bigger point about how AI might be warping our sense of value. You know, if AI can create music that's winning awards, what does that even say about the criteria we use to judge art? Are we losing sight of that human element?
I see what you mean. It's like, if algorithms start determining what's good, are we going to lose that human touch, that originality, that raw emotion that actually connects us to art?
Exactly. And it goes beyond just art, as his concern is that this flood of AI-generated content on social media could create these echo chambers.
Yeah.
Where we're just constantly interacting with these synthetic personalities and these manufactured emotions.
So it's like we're living in this simulated world.
Yeah.
and we're starved for real connection.
That's the fear.
Okay, so then how do we even navigate this? How do we separate what's real from what's fake? Especially when AI is getting so good at mimicking us.
It's uncharted territory for sure. And that's why it's so important to have these conversations now.
Yeah.
We need to figure out how to use AI's power, but also mitigate the risks. How do we ensure that it serves humanity and not the other way around?
Yeah. I think one thing that really stood out to me in the post is this call for us to be more critical consumers of information. You know, in this world with so much AI-generated content, we really need to step up our media literacy skills.
Absolutely.
We have to be able to spot the difference between fact and fiction, human expression, and content that's just been optimized for clicks.
And it's not just about being skeptical of everything we see online. It's also about understanding how our own behavior feeds into these algorithms.
Hmm.
The choices we make, the content we engage with, the data we share, it all plays a role.
So what can we actually do about it? Are there practical steps we can take to make sure we're not being manipulated?
Well, one strategy is to diversify our information sources. You know, don't just rely on social media or those personalized recommendations.
Right.
Actively seek out different perspectives. Challenge your own assumptions. Engage in thoughtful debate. Critical thinking is key.
So basically, don't just stay in your own little echo chamber. Make sure you're getting information from lots of different places.
Exactly.
But what about the AI-generated content itself? Is there anything we can do to curb its influence? Or is it just going to become more and more everywhere?
Well, one thing we can do is actively support and promote human-generated content.
Okay.
Seek out artists, musicians, writers, creators who are putting their heart and soul into their work. Engage in meaningful conversations. Share your own perspectives. Contribute to a culture that values authenticity and originality.
So by choosing to engage with that human-created content, we're kind of sending a signal.
Yeah.
That we still value that human touch.
Exactly.
We're not just passively consuming whatever the algorithms decide to show us.
Right. It's about making conscious choices.
Okay. So we've talked about being more critical consumers, actively seeking out diverse voices, and supporting human-created content. But it still feels kind of daunting, like we're fighting this uphill battle against this huge wave of AI.
It's understandable to feel that way, but remember, AI is a tool.
Right.
And any tool, it can be used for good or for bad.
Mm-hmm.
I think McElhenney's message is ultimately one of cautious optimism. He acknowledges the potential dangers, but he also believes that we have the power to shape it, to use it in a way that benefits humanity.
You know, it's funny, we keep talking about AI as a tool, but this post really made me think about how powerful and widespread it already is. It's not just some sci-fi thing anymore. AI is already having such a big impact, especially in creative fields.
It's crazy how fast it's moved into creative fields. Think about music. We've already got AI composing melodies, making backing tracks, even writing whole songs that sound just like famous artists. There are platforms like SoundDrop, where you can put in what genre you want, what mood, what tempo, and the AI will just make you a custom track.
I've messed around with some of those AI music things, and it's wild. Sometimes I genuinely can't tell if it's AI or a human composer. It makes you wonder, where's the line between human creativity and AI stuff?
Yeah, that's a big question a lot of people are struggling with. And it's not even just about replacing human artists. There's also this potential for AI to be a tool for collaboration, like a way for artists to try new things
and
push their boundaries.
Oh, yeah, I've seen some really cool examples of that. Musicians using AI to create these crazy soundscapes, or visual artists using it to make these really intricate patterns. It's like the AI becomes this creative partner helping them see things in a whole new way.
And that's where it gets really interesting philosophically.
Yeah.
Because it makes us rethink what creativity even is, what it means to be an author. Like, if an AI helps make a piece of art, who gets the credit? Who owns it? Those are big questions we're only starting to ask.
It's like we're redefining what it means to be human in this age of AI.
Yeah.
And it goes beyond art, too. Like, what about writing? Can we get to a point where AI is writing novels, screenplays, news articles? And we can't even tell the difference.
I mean, we're already seeing it for some types of writing. AI for marketing copy, social media posts, basic news reports. The tech is still new, but it's getting better fast. It's not that crazy to think AI could write more complex stuff soon.
But then how do we know what's real? What to believe? If we can't tell human writing from AI writing.
Yeah, it's a real challenge. It shows how important critical thinking is
and
media literacy. We have to be so aware of where information comes from and be able to spot the fakes.
So maybe this whole AI thing will force us to reevaluate what we actually value.
Right, because AI can already copy so much of what we thought was uniquely human.
It's like McElhenney is saying, in a world where AI can make art and music and writing, we'll have to figure out what truly makes us human, like our empathy, compassion, connection. Maybe we'll appreciate the things AI can't do.
I think that's a really good point. Maybe this AI revolution will lead us to a more humane world, where tech helps us be better people.
It's definitely a lot to consider. So as we wrap up this deep dive, I think the biggest thing for me is AI is here, and it's changing everything. We have to learn how to live with it, embrace the good parts, watch out for the bad parts, and most importantly, hold on to what makes us human in a world that's getting more and more dominated by machines.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
It's a journey we're all on together, and we're just getting started. So until next time, stay curious, stay informed, and stay human. Thanks for joining us for this deep dive